We are back with tonight's Outer Circle, where we reach out to our sources around the world. And tonight we begin in Cairo, where Iranian President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad was on an historic visit today. And, well, he was met with a shoe. Four men hurled shoes at Ahmadinejad as he shook hands with supporters. It's considered one of the biggest insults in the Muslim world. And this came on the first visit by an Iranian head of state to Cairo in 30 years. Reza Sayah is covering the story, and I asked him what punishment the throwers will get.
Aaron, the four men face jail time. They're out on bail right now, but they will be put on trial at some point. In the Muslim world, throwing a shoe at someone is one of the worst insults imaginable. It's like throwing dirt, filth, and anything else you may have stepped on at someone you don't like. And that's what happened to President Ahmadinejad last night during a visit to a mosque. He was walking through a crowd when all of a sudden someone launched a shoe at him. The shoe didn't connect. It hit a security guard. Prosecutors say right before the attacker threw the shoe, he yelled, "You killed our brothers." Perhaps a reference to the war in Syria. Iran, of course, backs the Assad regime in Damascus. Egypt does not. Aaron?
All right, thanks to Reza. And of course, this isn't the first time a world leader has been pelted with footwear. Remember back in 2008 when an Iraqi journalist launched both loafers at a very deft George W. Bush during a news conference? I don't think I could have reacted that fast. Obviously, at the time, it really wasn't funny. The man who did it was ultimately sentenced to a year in an Iraqi prison, but was released early for good behavior. And next to North Korea, where the country is pledging to carry out a, quote, higher-level nuclear test, the details are shrouded in mystery, but experts warn the test could happen with absolutely no warning. Anna Korin is following the story from the Korean demilitarized zone, and I asked her if there is any evidence to suggest how serious North Korea is.
Despite the threats and fiery rhetoric coming from North Korea, experts believe they're serious and ready to go. After the successful rocket test in December, Pyongyang is on a roll. And many fear that if this nuclear test goes off without a hitch, North Korea will emerge more aggressive than ever. Pyongyang conducted nuclear tests in 2006 and 2009 at its underground site in Punggye-ri on the northeastern tip of the country. Satellite imagery recently showed activity, and officials believe the third test will also be conducted here.